Happy Monday, everybody! You're listening to the Personal Playlist Podcast, fondly referred to as the P3. I'm Noah Daniel.
Music is a word within itself, with a language we all understand.
I am so excited to have Bill Cotter here on the Personal Playlist Podcast. Bill entered education after completing his MA in anthropology at UC Davis, where he conducted his fieldwork in Madagascar and Tanzania. After a year of teaching in California, Bill sought to combine his passions for education and travel by becoming an international school educator in 2009. During his 7 years abroad, Bill taught in China, Mexico, and Peru. In Peru, Bill helped build the Roosevelt Innovation Academy, a project-based program for high school students focused on real-world learning. After 8 years in the classroom, Bill took a remote-based position with Students Shoulder to Shoulder, a nonprofit focused on developing the next generation of ethical leaders by developing transformational experiences abroad for high school students. In his current role, Bill develops programming for high school students in partnership with 12 aspiring nonprofits spread across 4 continents. He's based in Costa Rica, where he lives by the beach with his wife and dog. Welcome to the show, Bill.
Thank you so much for having me. It's great to be here.
I'm so happy that you're here. We started talking, Evan introduced us, and you actually hosted something on Beluga that was about mentorship. And we at the mentoree were being interviewed by you. And that was the first time that we got to talk. And you and I had a lot to talk about in terms of mentorship. So why don't you tell us a little bit about why you value mentorship so much?
Yeah, actually, I remember back to that show when Evan first asked me to be on it. And I think it really spoke to me because at Students Shoulder to Shoulder, the idea of mentors and mentees is really important to us because there's a lot of programs that do, you know, high school student travel. And we're in that space, but we're trying to differentiate ourselves from that space in the sense that when students travel with us to work with one of our nonprofit partners during the summer, we hope that that's just the beginning of the experience. So once they come back from Peru or Panama, wherever they've been, we have a shoulder-to-shoulder network that they become a part of. And so we hope that we follow them and they follow us, you know, throughout their careers. So when they're high school students, we hope that they're reaching out to past alumni who are now in university to get some ideas and experience about, you know, applying to university, what university's like, maybe even going to visit them at that university. And similarly, when they graduate university and they're thinking about their first job and they're in their early career, we hope that the generation that's above them can serve as mentors as them as well. And then we have people in our network who are philanthropists or business partners who act as mentors to the students who are a little bit more advanced in their career journey. And so really what all of us do is we're hoping that at whatever stage you are at Shoulder to Shoulder, you have the chance to both be a mentor and be a mentee, no matter what stage of the journey that you're in.
Yeah, it's a really powerful thing. And I remember talking to you about community and how exactly what you're saying, you know, when you nurture people, especially through transformational experiences, like their opportunities to be, you know, a part of something bigger than themselves, then they really do have that that larger community to tap into, to be able to build from and hopefully be able to give back to.
Yeah, exactly. And I think because they have that shared experience, it doesn't necessarily have to be that they went to the same country, but they're all under that community of we've, you know, had a shoulder to shoulder experience. It makes it really easy to connect with others in that community because it gives you a shared language and you've all had that aha moment. So it really kind of paves the way just to be able to reach out to someone and ask them a question without knowing anything about them other than, hey, I know you went on Student Shoulder to Shoulder in whatever year it was. And that's enough to break the ice and really start the connection.
Yeah, I wanted to, the first time I met you, wanted to be like, hey, Mr. Cotter, and for any person in my generation. For me, seeing your name and then knowing that you refer to yourself as Bill, I can't tell you the nostalgia that it had for me. Did people do that to you in your life? Like,
yeah, it was. I didn't really know the show Welcome Back, Cotter, until I got to high school. And then a lot of my high school teachers, you know, on the first day, and of course you have like 6 or 7 different teachers. And so by like 7th period, you know, the first one or first two was kind of funny. And by 7th period, you're like, wow, I've heard that joke a lot today. But no. it was always done in like a friendly way. So even when you said it, it was like, oh, wow, it's like being back, you know, first day of high school. And, you know, you have the teacher up front who's trying to break the ice with everyone. And, you know, looking back now, being a teacher and probably thinking about, wow, there's probably things I said that students were like, wow, that was not funny, but I'm just going to laugh, you know? And so it's funny how it's come full circle, and it totally takes me back to being that, you know, high school student and laughing alongside my high school teacher on the first day of school.
It's funny because nostalgically, like, I love that show so much, but I think about the cohort of kids that were called the sweat hogs that were in Mr. Cotter's class. I think they would have really benefited from experiences that you offer. I'm thinking, like, I'm going to stay away from that nostalgia and bring you to the nostalgia that you're bringing here. So I asked you to prepare three songs, one that's nostalgic, one that reflects your identity, and one that picks you up, lifts you up, inspires, or motivates. Tell me a little bit about preparing your soundtrack for today.
Yeah, it was definitely an interesting exercise. I really appreciate it because I feel like I've listened to a lot of podcasts, and as I was going through it and thinking, I'm not quite sure what the reasoning is behind it. But as I was doing it, I was thinking, wow, this is a really interesting way to get to know someone without just like sending me a bunch of questions, right? It was like, you could tell a lot about a person, about their soundtrack, and kind of break the ice without sending them the formulaic, you know, tell me about this or tell me about that. So I really appreciated the preparation piece. And I was kind of imagining what was going on in your head in developing the podcast. And also like, oh, what is she going to think when I send these particular songs along? And I'm sure, as other guests have mentioned, you know, it's like asking someone what's their favorite restaurant or their favorite movie. You're like, wow, I only have to choose one. So fortunately, I guess with, you know, the advent of Spotify, I can go through and you can even look and see like, what are the songs that I listen to the most? And looking through, I know you probably, as I do, have way too many lists within Spotify, but I was looking through various lists of like, oh yeah, you know, motivational, what do I listen to if I work out or if I'm trying to get pumped up, or what are some other lists that might have these categories in there? So for me, it was a really fun journey yesterday of just listening to different songs and thinking like, oh, is that the one or is that the one? So yeah, thank you for the prompt, because it was a really fun journey and road that it took me down.
I'm so glad. Actually, this year Spotify sent out like a playlist of all the things you listen to most, and I was sitting with it differentiating which one were my plays and which ones were my daughter's, and some of them were more clear than others. But I think that that's true about memories too. And when you bring a nostalgic song, you know, a lot of things come up for you. This actually came from my classroom, this project, and I created it exactly in the way that you spoke about it. It was created so it wasn't a laundry list of questions to ask my students to get a sense of who they were, but to really take them on a journey to give a deeper sense of their identity. And they shared in the class, and my grade eights just finished presenting their P3s, and everybody's a little bit sad that we're not going to be listening to, you know, pieces of nine songs every day, because I don't do more than three presenters. But it's a profound way to get to know somebody. So let's start with your nostalgic song. Why did you choose it, and what does it say about you?
Yeah, it's a good question. Again, I was thinking, you know, nostalgic, where to go. And I instantly thought of, my dad was really, or is really, into music. And so I just remember so many times with him. I grew up in New York, and we had, on Long Island, and we had a small like cabin up in the mountains in upstate New York that we would try and escape to every now and again. And I remember like lots of long road trips with my dad in the car and just listening to his collection of music. And so when I thought of nostalgia, I instantly thought of like my dad's music choice, you know, road trips with my dad. And he loved Tom Petty. And so that particular song, Running Down a Dream, I just remember being in the car, you know, listening to the music, my dad blasting the music, and us just having a great time. And it was a way for us to share our interests and, you know, just to share that moment with each other through music. And similar to what you just mentioned as to the point of why you have people do this exercise, it's a way to enjoy something together when you're just in the car and you're not necessarily talking. But it provides sort of like the background soundtrack to the experience. So it took me back to those days of like being in the car and going on a road trip and, you know, spending time with my dad.
I was really excited. This was nostalgic for me. I used to work in a record store, and when Full Moon Fever came out, one of my favorite parts about this CD was that it wasn't an album or a tape, and yet at the end of it, they paused. And I think there were a few of the heartbreakers that were on this album, even though it was a solo Tom Petty album. And they would say, we'll just pause for you to turn the tape over or turn to the second side of the album. It was such a great shout out to the history of music. And there isn't a road trip I go on without Tom Petty, but it's so special that this is about you and your dad. Do you get to see your dad very often these days?
With the pandemic, not nearly as much, but, you know, prior to the pandemic, I taught overseas, as you mentioned in the introduction, for a while now, and I moved out of the United States, I guess, in 2010. So it's been a long time since I've actually lived back in the United States, but I try and get home a few times a year, and spend time with my family. So of course, travel right now is a bit grounded, but it's definitely something I make time for and I think that pandemic has definitely shown, I don't know where it is. There's a great article about how expats, I think, are starting to question their lifestyles a little bit and think about both their impact on the environment and what their choices mean. Because I think a lot of us move away from home and think, well, I could just, whenever I want, I can just hop on a plane. You know, I'm only 4 hours from Costa Rica. It's only 4 hours back home. I can do that a few times a year and have a great relationship with family and all that. And then when you're grounded in a way, it makes you think, wow, I took that ease of travel for granted. And, you know, what is the impact of living away or far from family and having to travel by air a few times to visit them? So it's definitely created, I guess, a lot of different questions in my head, the pandemic.
Yeah, I can see what you're saying. Well, I hope that this song just brings you joy. It's also the name of a documentary about this artist. So here's Tom Petty, Running Down a Dream.
Possible. Hit cruise control and rub my eyes. The last 3 days and the rain was unstoppable. It was always cold, no sunshine.
Trips really can feel like anything is possible, but by the sound of your identity song, I think that that's part of you too. So you chose an identity song that superficially you could think might have to do with you traveling to the places that you travel, but what else does it say about you?
Yeah, I think, you know, another thing I shared, you know, aside from the road trips, is that I'm a runner, and I feel like I've been running for as long as I can remember. And again, it's something I shared with my dad. You know, he's the person who got me into running, and really inspired my love of running. So, you know, when I hear that song too, I think about, you know, running with my dad. And, similarly too, I think, you know, at a deeper level, that idea of, like, you know, running down a dream, when I look at the life that I have today that I feel, you know, very privileged to have, I think about, my dad inspiring me and just saying, you know, basically whatever you want to do, you just got to run it down, you know, like you can dream it, you can be it, you can do it. My dad grew up or worked in construction, as I was growing up, and, you know, drove trucks and drove machines and had a really tough job, you know? And I think his message always to me was just like, if you go after it at school or just put your all into whatever you do and just really dream big, you know, you can be and do whatever you want and wake up and love what you do, you know? And I think that that really was motivation for me, was just seeing how incredibly hard he worked, but also how difficult, you know, that work was. And for him to say like, yeah, you know, if you run down your dream, you don't have to do this, and you can, and wake up and think, wow, I'm so lucky to do what I do. So I think that song on like on three different levels, I guess, in a way really connects me to my youth and also connects me to where I am today.
Yeah, I hear all parts of the P3 in there, you know, nostalgia, identity, and pick me up. But your next song, your identity song, is one that you chose by a really interesting and also traveling kind of oriented artist. What does this next song say about you?
Sorry, I mixed all of those together there. I was still thinking about running down a dream. And
No, I think it's beautiful. And you know what, one of the coolest parts, and there are many, of doing this recording every week, is that people discover parts of their themselves and the connections between their songs in new ways, just as it's happening and unfolding. So I think that that song is a really meaningful song for so much about you. So I'm so happy that that's where you went, because that's where you were supposed to go.
Yeah. No, yeah. And as you were thinking, I was like, oh, wow, I could have used that song for all three, because it is motivational for me as well. But so moving on to the actual song I chose for identity, which is Xavier Rudd, Follow the Sun. And again, I think, yeah, finding the identity one is probably, I felt maybe is the most difficult, because it's like, well, yeah, is there one song that I identify with? Or it really depends. I think it depends on the day too, right? I mean, it is your identity, but music very much, I feel like, shifts with your mood. But as I was searching through them, this particular song I really like, because on many levels it speaks to who I am. I definitely, you know, it, you know, begins with, you know, Follow the Sun. And I feel like for me, growing up at, you know, on Long Island, New York, I never traveled. I never got on an airplane actually until I was 18. But even prior to that, I just, for some reason growing up, I always thought that I wanted to end up in a Spanish-speaking country. And there was something about Central America that always spoke to me from the bits and pieces that I saw on TV and in magazines and things like that. And now I look and I'm, you know, I'm here in Costa Rica, and sometimes I look back and think, wow, I somehow sort of knew that somehow, but, you know, here I am. And for me, you know, Following the Sun is, I love being outdoors. I love surfing. And when I listen to the song, I can picture myself in Costa Rica and the many places I've driven, you know, throughout the country, listening to the song and thinking about, you know, following the sun and taking, you know, traveling to where your heart feels content and you feel like you're you. And it's definitely been a long journey, and there's been a lot of different places along the way. But when I arrived here about 2.5 years ago, I felt like, wow, this is the place, you know. There's and it's funny when I look at the song and it talks about, you know, the directions of birds and the sun and things like that. Whenever I'm out walking the dog here, and people always comment and say, wow, there's so many birds outside. There's so many noises. It's so, you know, it's so full of nature. So the song, I think, is very much part of who I am, in the sense that I really treasure each new day. I love traveling. I love being outdoors, nature, the sun. And I feel like when you listen to the song, it just inspires you really to think about, yeah, what do you want for your tomorrow? What's your intentions for it? And how are you going to do that?
And you really have, you've run down that dream, and you know, achieving that sense of peace with yourself, that you've gone to a place where you feel like you're always destined to be. That's a pretty special thing to be able to say so early on in your life. So let's play it.
Okay.
Xavier Rudd, Follow the sun. Like a sense of contentment or wholeness listening to that song in this context right now?
Yeah, absolutely. Every time I hear it, I feel that. And it's like, yeah, it's definitely, it's a song that I've always liked, but I feel like particularly here has sort of become the soundtrack to many aspects of my life here in Costa Rica. So yeah, I love it every time I listen to it.
So you have this wonderful essence where you have a whole feeling and this contentment listening to the song, but sometimes things can be difficult. And, you know, listening to you talk about being able to get home for the holidays or thinking about challenging times for kids that you must come into contact with, you came up with a song and I have a descriptor of pick me up or lift you up or pump you up or inspirational. How would you qualify this final song that you've selected?
Yeah, that was like, as I was reading those, I was like, is it a pick-me-up? Is it inspirational? Is it motivational? Is it pump-up? I guess it's kind of a mixture of all of them. It's actually a song that I had never heard before. And then I was doing something, I think I was home visiting my sister and it came on in the car and I just saw the excitement on her face and she just turned up the music and was like, you're going to love this. And just, I remember her just blaring the song and like that, the euphoria on her face and like, and then sharing the song with me. And so I picture that every time I hear that, I sort of like picture that smile on her face and that, like, I found this thing that you're going to love. So it's an electronic song, but I feel like if I'm just feeling down, I could turn it on and it's pretty hard to feel bad when you listen to it. Or if it's the end of a long work day and I'm like, all right, I got to get out for a run. And sometimes I run with music and sometimes I try to just, you know, clear my head and not run with music, but I'll listen to it, you know, and then head out without music. Or, you know, if I'm just struggling to get out there, I will put on my headphones and put that song on. And, you know, I find that I'm like out the door and running no problem at all. So, and it's, yeah, it's just a really feel good song. And then it's actually I remember my sister, it came on when she, at her wedding, and she like ran over to me and just like pulled me onto the dance floor and made sure that we danced to it as well. So I think it's a really motivational and uplifting song for me that makes me want to exercise. It makes me feel happy, but it also, I think, connects me to those times with my sister and, you know, picturing her happiness, also makes me happy. So it's kind of a combination of all those pick me up, motivational pump up songs that I just can't feel bad listening to.
Well, let's play it. Wake Me Up by Avicii.
Feeling my way through the darkness. saved by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I
have that whole idea about finding yourself even though you don't know you are lost.
Yeah. And I've actually haven't seen, when I was doing the research for, you know, this, the podcast, I've only listened to the song on Spotify or in the car or things like that. And I just didn't have time yesterday, but I marked it on YouTube. But apparently the music video that he made for that is sort of about like this businessman who decides like he doesn't want to do this anymore. And he like, everyone thinks he's kind of crazy and he's dancing on the tables and like just full of sheer happiness. And he's like, all right, I know what I want to do. Like I'm out of here. And so I really want to, I would like to check out the music video for that song later today. Cause I didn't know that beforehand. It was interesting as for the podcast, right? And think about the song, you start just looking into it a little bit more too, in anticipation of like, oh yeah, what is behind that song? So, and I think, in particular, too, I picked that song as like my motivational pick me up. And I think a lot of Avicii's songs are like that for people. But there was a 2007 documentary about him, and he's passed away, but his struggles with physical and mental health and the toll that, you know, music took on him, but also like that sort of struggle is where the music came from. And it was a really sad film. And so it's like this weird juxtaposition of when I hear that song, I think about all of the happiness that it brings to me. And then yeah, I also reflect on the documentary about his life and just how difficult being a successful musician was for him and the physical toll it took on him and the mental health toll it took on him and all of that. And it's just an interesting juxtaposition to think about.
Yeah, it's like some of the great artists across all the different mediums, their beauty is in their challenge and their struggle is their art. So I think it's an interesting point, and it's a dichotomy I think a lot of us are living right now as we try to find the sunshine in our lives and in this interesting circumstance. So how do you feel about sharing your P3 with me?
It was, I really, really enjoyed the exercise, and I'm excited to, you know, just ask people. I was actually doing this and thinking, you know, I'm always looking for, as you are, I'm always looking for new music and new ideas. And so, you know, I thought of like, I wonder if I could send out a quick survey to like a few good friends and family members and just say, hey, like around the holidays, since we can't be together, you know, if you could just put these three songs on our shared Spotify playlist, and then we can all just go through it. It might be really interesting to see what types of songs end up there, right?
I got a little emotional thinking that you guys could use that for a family connection. That's really cool. That's so cool. I'd love to know if you do that. Keep me posted. Let's send people to where they can find you, Bill.
Sure. I'm on Twitter at EDU Cotter, C-O-T-T-E-R. And also, if you'd like to learn more about students shoulder to shoulder, you can find us at shouldertoshoulder.com. And yeah, those are probably the two best places to get in touch with me.
Okay. Well, a quick shout out to Evan at Beluga for connecting us. Thank you so much for spending this time with me Is there anything you want to add before I play you out?
No, yeah, thank you so much for having me. And as you mentioned, thanks to Evan for connecting us. And I'm glad we had a chance to do this podcast. And for me, it just has me thinking of ways to connect with people in a time where we can't connect, whether it's asking people to share their P3s or, you know, maybe even doing a group Zoom and having people talk through these as we're doing. It'd be a really nice way to connect with people in a time where I think we're struggling to connect and you're not quite sure what to ask people about because everyone is just going through such different emotions right now. But to be able to connect over music and reflect over music, for me, I'm so excited about what this could mean for, you know, holiday Zoom parties, if you will.
I'm honestly really excited about that too. I never thought about it that way. And sometimes, you know, you're hanging out on Zoom and you're just kind of there and you don't know what to talk about, but you want to be together. What an interesting campfire to rally around. I hope you have a wonderful holiday and I look forward to connecting again at some point.
Yes, absolutely. I will. I hope to make that happen. I'll definitely let you know how it goes since you're, you know, the P3 podcast is the inspiration from that. So thank you so much for sharing the idea and inspiring me.
Okay. Well, have a great day.
Thanks. You too.
Thank you for joining us on the P3, the Personal Playlist Podcast. I'm Noah Daniel. This is Voice Ed Radio, and I hope you have a fantastic day.